One, go.
A few weeks ago, Pastor Brian asked me what theme I want to take up for my first sermon. There were several things available regarding the sign of the kingdom of God. Pastor Brian said to take my time choosing and respond the following week. But as soon as I saw the theme healing, I immediately said, I want to preach on that topic. For me, healing is the most directly connect with the story of my calling and also connect to my future ministry goal. Before I came to the United States to study theology, I studied clinical psychology in Korea and received my undergraduate and master's degree in clinical psychology. I want to help people who experience psychological trauma through the tool of science. Immediately after I graduate, I become a clinical psychologist and work at the hospital as an intern. The hospital was Seoul National University Hospital, which is the best university in Korea. Because of this, we had a very good medical service system and medical staff. I was very happy with my job until I met a client who was chronically depressed. This woman was a very long-term client who I met initially for an assessment. My supervisor told me this woman had already been treated with every method available, but they only worked temporarily. When I finally had a chance to meet with the woman, I noticed hopelessness in her voice. As we talked, I discovered she had extremely low self-esteem. No medicine or treatment or counseling session we used helped her. However, I felt that if she went to church and met God, she would quickly learn that she was loved by God. I want to share my good God with her, but under the rule of psychology, I could never speak of religion. I was very sad that I could not share my God with this woman. About 1 year after I met her, I saw her again. She was excited to tell me that she had started going to church and found out how much God loves her. She said that she was now a beloved daughter of God. When I spoke with my supervisor, he said her recovery was miraculous because she had recovered from the main issue, which was low self-esteem. This was my aha moment. As I was moving her chart to the storage section, I realized that here was my passion, sharing God's love with others. A few weeks, months later, I quit that job and now I'm here in seminary. I still enjoy clinical psychology and strongly believe in the science of MRI. I believe medicine is very effective, and I understand the importance of psychological treatment. But at the same time, I know God is a healer and a comforter, and today's text shows us Jesus, the healer, and highlights his healing power. I want to share two kinds of healing by Jesus that I see in today's text. Jesus went up to the Jerusalem, and near the sheep gate was a pool, which in Arabic is called Bethesda, meaning house of grace. There were so many people waiting that an angel came down and stirred the pool. The Bible says there were disabled, blind, lame, and paralyzed. The scene where Jesus saw the front of the pool reminds me of those times when our social system is caught up in competitions and injustice. The blind do not know where he or she is seated, so it is very hard for them to jump up when Basada is stirrup. The lame are maybe always late because they cannot run fast. Women, children, and elders also might struggle. This is a system based on competition. Jesus found a man who had been sick for 38 years. The man was sitting there because he had lost so many opportunities and had lost hope. So when Jesus asked him, "Do you want to be healed?" instead of just saying, "Yes," the man replied, "Sir, I have no one to help me into the pool when the water is still. While I am trying to get in, someone else goes down ahead of me." Jesus does not respond to the man by saying, "I will make the pool accessible for all everyone when the angel stood up." Instead, Jesus says, "Stand up, take up your mat, and walk." Jesus broke the Basada's healing rule of justice. Injustice. Jesus healed this man with his word. This is the first healing Jesus performed where he is healing people who are totally hopeless. And as he healed, he turned the system of competition upside down. He called the last to be the first and heals simply by speaking instead of calling anger to move the pool. Jesus overcome the human system of injustice and competition. Not only does Jesus heal disease, but he also liberates from the unjust system. Jesus healed in front of the pool named Basada, which means the grace house. From this, we can see that Jesus is the true Basada, the true house of grace. Since this is my first preaching here at Trinity UNC, I preached a lot about taking up a mat on the Basada and look up for clear meaning of what this meant for Jews and Christians of this time. But after speaking with some close friends, I decided to change my focus and talk about something else. In this healing story, Jesus said to the man, "Stand up, take your mat and walk." Jesus could have just said, "Stand up, go and walk." However, Jesus said, "Take your mat." What is the importance of the mat? The mat represents the long 38 years the man suffered. The man is old and smelly, and the man no longer has need for this unclean mat. Now, he stands up in a new life that is totally different from the past 38 years. For him, when Jesus said, "Take your mat and walk," Jesus means to take your pain and suffering and move forward, walk on into your future. Everybody experiences illness and sickness. Most people experience stress, and some of us have been deeply wounded by life. Some people have experienced failure, and some may have experienced disappointment. We all have the memory of the mat in our life story, but Jesus says, "Take your mat." The mat represents the history of our sickness, our shame, our disappointment and unhappy moment in our lives. But after recovered, our mat is no longer our dark history. The mat, the evidence that we have been healed by the grace of God. It is the evidence that I'm not anymore the same person, sick, stressed, or a failure. Jesus came to heal the man, and this is the second part of the healing Jesus chose us today. As we surrender our lives, the will of God, we carry our mat as a reminder of His grace and healing power. If you have a mat in your life story, I hope that after worship, when you go out, we can all take our mat with us, believing that through Jesus Christ, we are healed. Because with our mat, we can be a witness for the healing power of Jesus. Sometimes, I miss my white intern psychological gown. It is true, but I can share my healer Jesus with people. However, I remember the client who totally recovered after meeting God, and remember her eyes full of the hope and joy. I know that my God is a healer, and I want to share my God with all people. This made me very happy. Amen.